Hello children, Leaves in Our Lives Part 2. In a previous video about leaves in our lives, we have discussed about leaves diversity. In this video, we will discuss about parts of leaves. A leaf mainly consists of a leaf plate, midrib, veins, petiole and stomata. I have a mango leaf with me, and the broad and flat portion of the leaf, this area is called leaf blade or lamina. It is generally broad and flat. Plant makes their food in this layer. It is usually green in color. Veins. The thin lines on the upper surface of the leaf is called veins. In the picture also you can see the thin lines, they are called veins. It provides support for the leaf to make it sturdy, and it also transports water, minerals and food to the leaf. It acts like pipes, small pipes for transportation of water, minerals and food. Midrib. Can you see the middle line? That is called midrib. It is the main vein. The main vein is called midrib. It is the thin tube running in the middle of the leaf. The thin tube running in the middle of the leaf is called midrib. All the veins are connected to the midrib. In the picture you can see all the veins are connected to the main vein, that is called midrib. This midrib are made of double pipelines of cell. See, it also acts like pipe for transportation of water and minerals. So one pipe, it carries water and minerals to the cell of the leaf. The plant need water and minerals for making food. So one pipe, it carries water, minerals from the soil, from the root. And the other pipe carries the prepared food. After they prepare their food, they need to be carried to other parts. So the other pipe, it carries the prepared food to the other parts of the plant. Then we have stalk or petiole. This portion is called petiole. Can you see this one? This portion is called petiole. So the main function of petiole is it joins the blade to the stem. Like here I have hibiscus plant, so the petiole, it connects the leaf with the main stem. This is the main stem, so it is connected by a petiole. So this portion is called petiole. Then we have stomata. Stomata are tiny pores present on the underside of the leaf. So we cannot see with our bare eyes. So we need microscope to see stomata. So it is present underside of the leaf. They are tiny pores, okay, tiny holes. These holes help in exchange of gases and water. Like plants need carbon dioxide to make food. I will explain this in the next video, how plants make food. So plants need carbon dioxide to make food. How it will take? We use our nose to take air. So the same way leaves use stomata for exchange of to take gas or to give out gases from the plants. Children, so in this video, hopefully you have understood about different parts of a leaf. So you can take a leaf and you can also identify the different parts. If you want, you can also draw it and label the different parts of a leaf. Thank you, children.